Now let's do something even more interesting.
Okay, let me place this large metal object in the middle.
Yes, if I just place this marble here, you will see that it just dropped into the middle of the massive object. Now let's see what happens if I give it a little push. What do you notice now?
I see the marble going around the massive object in the middle.
Yes, this is how all celestial objects move around a more massive object. The Earth, for example, does not just drop into the Sun. It actually orbits the Sun. And you can see that it goes round and round because it has velocity. Now, observe it more clearly. What do you see about the object? You see that as it gets closer to the massive object, it gets faster, as predicted by your law.
Yes, it does!
That's because the slopes get steeper and steeper as it gets closer to the massive object. Now, what's the other thing you observe? Let's see that again. What's the other thing that you observe?
Oh, I noticed that the orbit is getting smaller as it goes around the massive object.
Precisely.
This is different from how the Earth's orbit means approximately the same distance from the Sun.
Well, it has got to do with another one of your laws, Newton.
My law? Which law?
Well, it is Newton's first law of motion.
Oh, that one. My law states that an object at rest stays at rest and an object in motion stays in motion unless the opposing force is acting on it.
Right. So what is that force that is causing the marble's orbit to get smaller and smaller?
I am not sure.
Well, it's actually friction. In our model here, our fabric has some friction. So energy is being lost due to friction, and the marble's orbit gets smaller and smaller. For celestial objects, there is no opposing force in space that is causing the object's orbit to get smaller and smaller. So don't you think that is a very fortunate thing for us humans on this Earth?
Why?
Well, we don't want to be fried chickens, right? If the Earth spirals into the Sun after some time.
I hope you have found that interesting. Now let's continue our journey by looking at the effect of this movement of celestial object on the massive object that they are orbiting in the next video. Please like, share and subscribe to the channel and click the bell so that you will not miss our upcoming videos. See you in our next video. Thank you.